In this lesson, you will learn how to create V-Ray HDRI lighting in 3ds Max. Let's start by creating V-Ray HDRI map. Open the material editor and select V-Ray HDRI. Click on the Browse button and select your HDRI image. I'm using These People's Free HDRI number 3. We need to change the mapping type from angular to spherical. Let's close this little preview. Next, we want to preview our HDRI in the main viewport. To do so, open the environment window under the rendering tab and drag the V-Ray HDRI onto the environment map. Make sure you set it as an instance. Now go to the viewport configuration. Select the background tab and select Use Environment Background. Apply to Active View to enable the changes. It's time to create a V-Ray dome light for our HDRI image. Place the light anywhere in the scene. While the light is selected, go to the Modify panel and scroll down to this Texture S section. Drag the HDRI to the DOM texture map as an instance. Before we make a test render, let's check our render and camera settings. In the render setup, make sure that the GI is on and that you are using Irradiance Map and Light Cache. I'm using V-Ray Physical Camera with default exposure value. The only thing I've changed is the focal length in order to get a wide angle image. Let's make a test render. We can see that our image is a bit dark at this moment and the shadows are too weak. To fix the light intensity, we can simply boost the render multiplier of the HDRI. Let's try a value of 2. The exposure of the wall looks okay for now. Don't worry about the blown-out sky, we will deal with that later on. The sun direction isn't producing any interesting shadows right now. By changing the horizontal rotation, we can move the HDRI position right or left. If you're having a hard time seeing the exact position of the sun, you can reduce the overall multiplier of the image to see it more clearly. I'm going to set the rotation to -150. and bring back the overall multiplier to 1. Let's see what we have so far. The shadow direction is better now, but they are still too weak. To make them stronger, we need to increase the contrast of the HDRI. In the inverse gamma section, set a value of 0.7. The shadows are much more defined now. Try not to set a value lower than 0.7 or 0.5, otherwise you will get unwanted results. Another thing you should pay attention to is the noise produced by the HDRI light. To get a cleaner result, we need to change the dome light subdivision. ThirtyTwo subdivision should be okay. The render time is longer with high subdivisions, so it's a good idea to change it only in the final render. Let's switch to a night lighting. Just replace the current image with a night HDRI image and adjust the render intensity if needed. We've set up our HDRI correctly, but we won't be able to replace the sky later on in Photoshop because the light dome is currently blocking the alpha channel. To change this, select the light and in the modify panel tick the invisible button. Lastly, uncheck the use map in the environment window and keep the color as black. Now the alpha channel is visible.